Hi, I'm Michelle and welcome to The Snugglery. I usually post videos about knitting and crocheting, and I promise that crochet pattern I mentioned in the last video is coming soon, but I've been a little busy. I recently begun the massive undertaking of moving my blog from Wix to WordPress. And I didn't know anything about WordPress going into this, and I've learned a lot that I kind of wanted to sprinkle out there into the internet, just in case there's anybody else out there who's looking to move their blog. And I know a lot of you crafters out there dabble in blogging as well, so hopefully you find this video helpful if you're considering blogging platforms or if you currently have a Wix website and you've been thinking about moving to WordPress. First of all, I really recommend that you do, that you move your website from Wix to WordPress. Think of it like renting versus owning. I'm going to have so many more options with my website now that it's on WordPress, and it really made all of the stress and headaches worth it. My next little tip or bit of advice is to not focus so much at first about transferring your content. I had like tunnel vision about transferring my content. I thought, how am I gonna move these blog posts? How am I gonna move this shop? And that really should be like the last step. You first wanna make sure that you have a solid website to move all of your content to. And I'll go over a little bit the order of steps that I think you should follow to move your website from Wix to WordPress. First of all, if your domain is hosted through Wix, you're going to have to get a new domain host because Wix won't let you host a URL that points anywhere but a Wix website. So you're going to have to choose a domain host. I chose Bluehost before I really did enough research, and they've been fine. The customer service has been good. I don't think my website is as fast as it could be. Whatever domain host you choose is really going to depend on the individual needs of your website. So I'm going to link a couple of videos down below of much more knowledgeable individuals comparing and contrasting the different domain hosts that I kind of wish I watched before I chose mine. But really, Bluehost has been okay. And then what you're going to want to do is initiate your domain name transfer. It's kind of scary to do that immediately without having a new website to move to yet, but the domain name transfer itself takes like 14 days. And over the course of those 14 days, you can be working on your WordPress site. Then when your WordPress site is done, you'll have your domain at your new host and you can point it to your new WordPress site and have virtually no downtime for your website. So that's where I'm at right now. I waited too long to transfer my domain name, so my website still points to Wix, even though my WordPress site is basically all built out. And I'm just waiting out those 14 days to get my domain name officially transferred. So you're going to want to pick a host, get the transfer initiated ASAP. Then we can start thinking about building out your WordPress site. One of the first things you do when you start to build a WordPress site is you pick a theme. And themes are just like themes on Wix. It kind of establishes the aesthetic of your website. It's where you pick like your default colors, and themes are very important for WordPress. But some things you want to consider when you're choosing a theme, besides just how it looks, is what page builder you're going to use, and do you want to have a store, a blog, or both? If you want to have a store, you're going to want to choose a theme that is compatible with WooCommerce. WooCommerce is the name of the main store plugin that is used with WordPress. By the way, plugins in WordPress is basically like what apps are in Wix. And then I mentioned something called page builders. What a page builder is a plugin that adds the drag and drop kind of visual page building functionality that everybody loves so much about Wix. You can get that in WordPress too. You don't have to build your website completely in code from the back end. You can build a WordPress site without having any coding experience thanks to these page builders. I'll list a few of the most popular page builders, and the only one that I have experience with so far is Elementor. And I found Elementor's interface very intuitive. It reminded me a lot of Wix, and I was able to make very beautiful pages using Elementor. And before you choose a page builder, I recommend that you watch some tutorials of other people demonstrating how to use other page builders so you can kind of see what the interface looks like and figure out which one is going to be the most intuitive for you, because you'll use the page builder not only to build your main website, but also to create your blog posts from this point forward. So the same way that in a Wix blog post, you were able to add galleries, embed videos, you will get all of that functionality from your page builder as well. So once you pick a page builder that you like, you'll have to look for a theme that is compatible with that page builder. Now, I actually did not wind up going with a page builder per se, because through my research, I discovered that WordPress is kind of starting to roll out its own page builder. It's called Gutenberg, and I ultimately decided to go with Gutenberg for my website because I felt like it kind of future-proofed my website. I had just broken up with Wix, and a lot of the page builders have free and premium versions, and I was afraid to get locked into a relationship with a page builder that would be similar to my experience with Wix, where I just kept having to pay more money and upgrade my package to get more functionality as my website grew. But Gutenberg is free. And the cool thing about Gutenberg is that there are plugins for additional Gutenberg blocks. Those blocks are the little widgets that you drag and drop to build your page and to add functionality to your blog posts. And unlike the other page builders, if you needed to switch for some reason, you also might have to switch your theme, which switching your theme is kind of like A-bombing your site and having to start over from the beginning. But with Gutenberg, you can swap out different Gutenberg block plugins to give different ones a try without ever having to change your theme, because it's all still under the Gutenberg umbrella, if that makes sense. If this is all kind of, don't worry about it, watch some tutorials for the most popular page builders, watch some tutorials for Gutenberg, and then if you must, dabble around with them yourself and see which one you find the easiest and most intuitive to create a website that you like, and more importantly, that you can customize and edit yourself, because it's your blog. You're going to have to add more blog posts in the future, and you'll be building them from now on with this page builder slash post builder that you choose. So the other main thing that you're going to have to always be thinking about with WordPress is site load speed. Wix kind of took care of a lot of this for us. I mean, first of all, Wix sites don't load the fastest anyway, but you don't even have to worry about it because Wix already has a bunch of these features built in that you probably didn't even notice. The main one being something called lazy load, which is where smaller versions of your photos actually load first so that most of the content of the site gets loaded as quickly as possible. But with WordPress, you're on your own. So it's up to you to make sure that your photos aren't too big, that you don't have too many blocks going on any one page, and you'll want to constantly be checking your site speed via Google's like site speed tester, because the faster your site loads, the better it is for SEO and your reader's experience. Nobody wants to sit there waiting for a website to load forever. So one of the main things I had to do before I actually started transferring over all my content is all my photos, and I have a lot of photos, were too big. You absolutely want to keep each photo under 1 megabyte, and most of my photos were over 1 megabyte. Really, the smaller the better. And you may be wondering how you can do that without decreasing your image quality. I'll link to a couple websites where you can batch optimize your images to make them smaller, and it doesn't reduce the quality at all. There's also plugins to optimize your photos after the fact, but I really recommend that you do it manually ahead of time. Just on your computer, keep a file folder of all your original photos, then of all your optimized photos, and only upload the optimized ones to WordPress. Once you have your host picked, your domain transfer initiated, your theme and page builder selected, and all of your images optimized to be the smallest file size that they can be while not decreasing the quality of your images, then it's finally time to start thinking about transferring over your content, your blog posts, whatever's written on your site, your About Me section, your contact section, and your products if you have any. Now, unfortunately, the best way to do this, and kind of the only way to do this when you're moving from Wix to WordPress, is copy. Paste, copy, paste, copy, paste, copy, paste, copy, paste, over and over and over and over again until you lose your mind. When you begin researching how to move your blog posts from Wix to WordPress, you may encounter words like importer, RSS. Hi, Editing Michelle here. I forgot to mention that the RSS feed from a Wix blog only contains the last 20 posts, which isn't too helpful if you have 60 plus posts like I did. And furthermore, it didn't work. I wasn't able to use the WordPress RSS importer to import my RSS feed from my Wix blog. I kept getting an error message, and I contacted my host about it. I even hired a webmaster to do it for me, and she couldn't figure out what the problem was, so the RSS feed import just didn't work. And I still don't know why. Just thought you should know. And there's even companies that claim that they can do this for you. I looked into a lot of those website importer companies, and I had a hard time substantiating their claims. They don't seem to be as popular as they make themselves out to be, and if they really could do what they claim to do, I think that people would use them a lot more often. Also, they cost money, and you really can do this yourself. Honestly, I'd rather do a separate video on how to move each individual blog post, because I have come up with some tips and tricks on how to make it easier while you're copying and pasting your blog posts. It wound up not taking me that much time. But my number one tip is that you don't want to copy and paste your blog post from the back end of Wix, where you would go to edit your blog post. Don't copy and paste from there. Just go to the post on your actual website where anyone can see it. Copy the content from there and paste it into WordPress. And when you copy and paste your blog post, your photos will come too. But they won't be stored on WordPress. They'll still be hosted through Wix. I haven't been able to test to see if those hosted photos still work after I officially move my domain and lower my Wix subscription to the free version. But for now, I'm going to keep those photos hosted at Wix just to save myself time and to save my WordPress site some storage space. And we'll see if I can continue to host those blog images on Wix even after I downgrade to the free version of Wix. Then when it comes to moving a store of any kind, you'll get the WooCommerce plugin on WordPress, and you can actually pick up an Excel spreadsheet of all of the data about your products from Wix and use the WooCommerce importer to import that data. I actually wasn't able to use this because Wix doesn't let you create an Excel spreadsheet with your data from digital products, and all my products are digital. So to move digital products from Wix to WordPress, you will have to copy and paste all the data from every listing that you have. I did find one interesting workaround to get at least the title and description from every one of my products from Wix to WordPress in one batch, but that too is kind of beyond the scope of this video. And if anybody's interested, I'll do a video about how to move your digital products from Wix to WordPress in the easiest way. So this video is getting kind of long, and honestly, I'm exhausted, but it's going to be so worth it when I can finally have a website that is completely mine, that I can customize to no end. And I'm actually really excited about all of the potential and creativity that I can now have with my site since it is off of Wix. So in summary, your transfer from Wix to WordPress will look a little something like this. You'll get a new domain host, transfer your domain, then you'll pick a theme, a page builder, start rebuilding every page of your website. Then you can copy and paste all of the content from your Wix site to your new WordPress site. And finally, when your domain is officially hosted at the new domain host, you can point your domain to your new WordPress site and officially downgrade your subscription on Wix to the free version and be done with Wix. Now, every stage of that process can be expanded on. How do you point a domain to a new website? How do I change all the URLs so that the about page from Wix is now the about page on WordPress? You know, how do I make sure this doesn't totally screw up my SEO forever? And each topic really can have its own video. I don't want this to drag on too long. So I'm going to have a wealth of information down beneath this video, how I learned about all of these things. And I'll also have links to both of my websites so you can see how the Wix site looks and how my new site's turning out. And please let me know in the comments below if you found any of this helpful or if there's any aspect of the Wix to WordPress blog transfer process that you think is especially daunting or that you want to hear how it went in a little more detail. And I'll think about another couple of videos maybe in this sort of blogging area. And also, if you don't know how to knit or crochet, I've got a couple videos for that, so please stick around on this channel and enjoy everything else it has to offer. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for being patient with me if you're normally here for knitting and crocheting patterns. I can't wait to get back to knitting. I'm not a webmaster. Really, this whole process has kind of been a damper on the creative mojo, but hopefully now that my blog is on WordPress, I can get back to doing what I love, which is knitting and crocheting. So I'll see you next time. Bye.